Hey everybody, my name is David Pegler. This is your pre-London outlook for January the 30th. Happy Friday, everybody. Let me take this opportunity to remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. Myself and none of the other currency coaches will make any trade recommendations during the course of a day. But what we will do is conduct some fundamental and technical analysis and hopefully help you put together some very profitable trade plans. Please remember, trading is always very risky business. And do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success on a demo account. No reason to risk your hard-earned money when there's a safer environment to get that handled. Okay, this is a pound dollar hourly chart that, remember, we put together a pound dollar plan yesterday to sell us down to around the 140 area and then look for reasons to buy. Well, we got the price action we wanted. I just wasn't, I was off a few pips on where and where the bounce would be. So I hope that, I hope that you were able to capture this. You know, we sold this down just as predicted. All right, we got a little pullback of that 2 hour 21. We then came down and then rallied hard off the bottom. And if you look at the 15 minute, we had, We had a good few clues here, guys. I mean, just using the price action lesson that I spoke about yesterday, you know, making nothing but a series of higher highs and higher lows, and off she goes, you know what I mean, all day long, all the way down to the bottom. Nice little fib. Does that mean that the overall little downtrend here is done? No. All right. But the fact that you have now breached the swing high gets you thinking that the possibility of a higher low is possible. But, you know, given, you know, we bottomed out at M1, for London, and subsequently rallied up to the 200. So a lot of times that's just another selling opportunity for lower lows, okay? But as soon as you broke back above this 200 after forming a little 1-2-3 reversal pattern at the bottom here, the writing was on the wall, folks. You know, at that point, you got to get long. And pound Swissie, pound yen, and pound dollar are all very, very similar trades. And it's just the price action we wanted. Remember, I explicitly said yesterday that we were waiting for a higher low right at that support level. Well, you know, it just so happened that we were at the 2 hour 55 when this occurred. Let me show you that. 2 hour chart's very valuable, folks. It really, really is. And, you know, here we are. We came down. Bottom of the 2 hour Bollinger Band plus the 55 EMA. This is also the 4 hour 21. And, you know, subsequently rallied off it. Well, now, if I just take you back to that pound dollar 15, now we are, you know, here's the hourly. Now we've effectively double topped, okay? Double top is a reversal pattern by itself. And there's something to note in the market right now, okay? And this is just a generic statement in terms of investing and trading in general. Is in my tenure as a trader, I've noticed that sometimes things don't make sense necessarily from a fundamental standpoint, but more so from a cash flow standpoint. So at the moment, we got money coming out of treasuries in unprecedented fashion, yields rising, but we got the stock market falling, okay? Top money and bailouts on the way, therefore money's getting pumped into gold. So it's just a case of we haven't really accomplished anything. We've just moved money around. And we've seen that again in, to a lesser extent, the yen, but definitely back into the dollar. So we might as well concentrate on trading the USD as an entity today. So I wanted to just show you some support and resistance here on pound and then take a look at euro, okay? So just keep that in mind, guys. You know, you have to be able to identify the cash flow, because at the moment we've had, you know, massive rallies in gold, but we've seen dollar strength. And I'm sure some people have been trying to fight the dollar strength because of the correlation with gold, and there's no need to. It's simply a matter of cash flow, okay? You know, typically, gold is the ultimate anti-dollar. Well, when there's this much money coming out of treasuries and people are hedging, you know, hedging against inflation, well, they, you know, the result of the matter is a big rise in gold and some strength in the dollar, which is actually contrary to conventional thinking behind correlations and commodity and currency correlations, okay? So don't confuse it, all right? I guess that's really my message here. Don't confuse it. Just stay grounded as to what the where the money's going, all right? Now, we've now double-topped on this hourly here for cable, and if you just take a trend line from the bottom, this is very, very trappable, guys. Very, very trappable, little wedge shape. And, you know, it's just a case of trading the breakout. Oopsie daisy. Just a case of trading the breakout today. You know, if we break below 42, I think you've got to be bearish. And if we break above here, you have to be pretty bullish. Pound Swissie and Euro Pound have really told the story with regards to the pound dollar itself of late. So I encourage you to look at those on a daily basis if you're trading any type of pound for some type for some sort of relative strength and correlation. A lot of times in London we've been trading the European pairs as opposed to the dollar, and there's a difference. Okay, so if we break below this trend line, it's just a case then of seeing us pop below 41.80, and then looking for a little fib back to retest this trend line, and then hey, we're gonna test that 140 and possibly the 139.20 area. Okay, I'm not gonna spend too much time on cable. It's very cut and dry what's going on here. We're now trapped between support and resistance, no question. Okay, let me go over to Euro. This is a Euro dollar daily chart that we've had. Okay, and this trend line at the bottom here looks a little bit like that pound hourly does, right? This little trend line here has been very significant. We bounced off it a good ways. This is a daily chart after all. Excuse me. Bounced off it a good ways. And have subsequently, now we're going to retest it. Well, we've tested this thing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this will be the sixth time that we're down here. Okay, but this is the first time in a while that we've come down here after making a rally. Okay, after making a large rally too far, too quickly, down, bounced off it again, but now we have a significantly lower high. Significantly lower. So it just tells me that there wasn't that much buying interest in it this first time. It was more of a respect type bounce. Okay, and if you just take a look at the weekly, I know the weekly, we now have the 5 EMA, a little 5A cross here. Okay, pushing right into price. So I think if we can break this, we're now going to go and test the support area around 25.59. Well, that's significant because this week's weekly M1 is sitting at 25.58. All right, so there's a little confluence area and a good target for today. Same exercise, you know what I mean? Wait for the break of this 28.85 to 28.80 area, and then fib your way into it. So you want to be, even if you're in a downtrend, guys, it's always important to remember, even on a breakout, is that you're selling at resistance in the context of a downtrend. So you're not just, oh, it's broken, I'm short. Okay, you're letting it break, you're letting it pull back. So you're selling at some level of resistance. Remember what resistance is. It's an area of implied selling. The same as support is an area of implied buying. All right? Conversely said, support's an area of demand and resistance an area of supply. Okay, so if you want to be a seller in a down market, you want to be a seller at areas where there are sellers. All right? I know that's a rhetorical statement, but it makes sense, doesn't it? You want to be selling where you overbought in the context of a downtrend. All right? You do not want to be selling when you oversold in the context of a downtrend. Or even worse, keep buying after there's been buying in the context of a downtrend. All right? You want to be selling after there's been buying when you overbought in the context of a downtrend. And the same applies for breakout. We got our trend line pushing through the bottom at around 28.80. All right, wait for the break. Let Asia give us that little pullback that we need, and then sell it at a fib resistance level, retested the trend line support, and off she goes. And, with the right levels of confirmation, there's no reason why you shouldn't think long off that trend line. But I'm skeptical, seeing that we've tested it so many times over the last few days, all right, and weeks. So that's the little trade plan. I'm just looking for breaks below 28.80 and fib short kind of ideas. And above it, perhaps you get a decent pullback back to around 29.50 for another selling opportunity. Okay? And on cable, just watch out for that little hourly trap. We have double top now and are testing the central pivot point for the day. All right? My name is David Pegler, folks. Really simple stuff today. This has been your pre-London outlook for January the 30th. Good luck today, folks, and happy trading. I'll catch up with you Monday.